Good morning, students. In the last video, we have studied about resources. With the resources, we can produce various goods. In order to produce goods, we need industries. So today, we are going to study about industries. What is an industry? Industry is a place where the raw materials are processed into finished products. This sector is called as the value addition sector. First, let us study about the classification of industries. On the basis of we can classify the industries on the basis of size, nature of raw materials, source of raw materials, and ownership. On the basis of size, industries may be classified into large scale industry, small scale industry, and cottage industry. It depends upon the investment or the capital. Second one is nature of raw materials. It depends on the raw materials. What type of raw material is used? When it is heavy raw material, it is called as heavy industry. When the industry uses light raw material, then it is called as light industry. Third one is on the basis of source of raw materials. That is from where they get that raw materials. When they get raw materials from agriculture, then it is agro-based industries. When it is from minerals, or when they use minerals as their raw materials, then it is mineral-based. When they get raw materials from forest, then it is forest-based industries. Then last one, ownership. According to the ownership, when it is owned by an individual, it is called as private sector. When it is owned by the government, it is called as public sector. When it is owned by both private and public, it is called as joint sector. And when it is owned by a group of people, then it is called as cooperative sector. In your lesson, we are going to study about agro-based industries, forest-based industries, and mineral-based industries. First, let us see what do you mean by agro-based industries. These industries draw their raw materials from agricultural sector. First, let us study about cotton textile industry. Cotton textile industry is considered as the oldest industry in India. Textile, when we say, it may be cotton, jute, wool, silk, and synthetic fiber textiles. In India, with 3,400 textile mills, with installed capacity of more than 50 million spindles and 8,42,000 rotas, is the second largest in the world. The first cotton textile mill was established at Fort Gloucester near Kolkata in 1818. Traditional sectors like handloom, that is only with hand they made the clothes in those days. Handicrafts, again it is handmade goods. And small power looms, they used a lightweight material, that is machineries we can say, small power loom units, are the biggest source of employment for millions of people in rural and semi-urban areas. It contributes 7% of industrial output. Industrial output, when we say, it includes the production of all the industries. It is not only cotton textile, it includes textile industry, iron and steel industry, cement industry, all the industries. So 7% of industrial output from India is shared by cotton textile industry. And 2% of GDP, that is gross domestic product. What is gross domestic product? That is the value of final goods and services produced within the territory during that particular period of time. Mostly 1 year, okay? That is called as gross domestic product. So 2% of gross domestic product is shared by this industry. And 15% of country's export earnings are only from cotton textile industry. It gives employment for 45 million people. At present, 1,719 mills are there in our country. In that, 188 mills are in public sector, 147 in cooperative, and 1,284 in private sector. India is the third largest producer of cotton and has the largest loom and ring spindles in the world. About 16% of industrial capacity, 14% of industrial production and over 20% of industrial labor are engaged in cotton industry. Next, what is the process of ginning? Ginning is nothing but it is the separation of cotton fiber from the cotton seed. Okay, they have to break open the cotton seed in order to take out the fiber. That is only called as ginning. These industries are located mainly in Mumbai. So, Mumbai is known as the Manchester of India. The factors which favor the cotton textiles in Mumbai. The first factor may be availability of black soil. I think you all know that black soil is necessary for the cultivation of cotton. Since it is available in Mumbai, that is the first factor which favors the cotton textile industries. The next one, humid climate. The climate must be humid or else the yarn may be broken when they spin the yarn. Next, they have that port facilities. The port facilities help them to import the machineries and to export their products to other countries. Then they need the power, electricity. Since there is availability of hydel power, that is also one of the favorable factor. Then in order to sell their products, they needed a good market. That market facility is available in Mumbai. And the last one may be they have good transport facilities. The roadways are there, railways are there, port facilities are there, airways are there. Since they have all means of transport available in Mumbai, that is the factor which favors the cotton textile industries in Mumbai. These industries are mainly concentrated in Maharashtra, Gujarat, West Bengal, Uttar Pradesh and Tamil Nadu. In Tamil Nadu, Coimbatore has 200 mills out of 435. Okay, in Tamil Nadu we have totally 435 mills. In that 200 mills are only in Coimbatore. So, Coimbatore is known as the Manchester of South India. What are the other places where we can find cotton textile industries in Tamil Nadu? Erode, Tirupur, Karur, Chennai, Tirunelveli, Madurai, Thoothukudi, Salem and Virudhunagar. The next textile may be jute textiles. Jute is a low priced fiber used mainly for making package materials like gunny bags. Jute is nothing but we say in Tamil sanal. Okay, gunny bags are saku. It may be even blended with cotton. Blended means mixed with. Okay, sometimes it may be mixed with cotton and wool in order to produce textiles. India contributes how many percentage of world's output? 35% of jute goods are only in India. Okay, in the total world's production, jute production, India produces 35%. This textile industry is second after cotton textile industry. Jute is also known as the golden fiber. It is renewable, natural, biodegradable and eco-friendly. Mainly jute industries are located in Hooghly River Basin. It needs fresh water for retting process. You have studied already under cotton ginning process, removal of fiber. Here, to remove the fiber, jute fiber, they use retting process. What is that retting process? They have to cut the bark of the tree and soak it in water, that is fresh water, for 2 to 3 weeks. Then the bark of the tree will become soft. They will remove the fiber from that. So, they need fresh water for this process. The first jute mill was established by George Auckland in 1854 at Risha, near Kolkata. India stands first in the production of raw jute and jute goods next to Bangladesh. Jute products are gunny bags, canvas, pack sheets, jute web, carpets, cordage, hessian and twines. It is also used in plastic furniture. Bleached fiber is blent with wool. mixed with cotton to make carpet and blankets. Let us see what are the factors which favor jute textiles in West Bengal. The first one, since it is nearer to the Hooghly Basin. I told you, in order to do that process retting, they need fresh water. Since the Hooghly River is nearby, that is the first most important factor which favors jute textiles in West Bengal. Next one, inexpensive water transport is provided by Hooghly River. Third one, this Kolkata or West Bengal is also well connected with railways, waterways and roadways. And there is availability of abundant water for processing, I said already. Availability of cheap labor. The labor is also cheap. They are from West Bengal, Bihar, Odisha and Uttar Pradesh. And last one, Kolkata has a port and large urban center. It provides banking facility, insurance and port facilities. Because of all these factors, there is a lot of jute textile industries in West Bengal. The next industry what we are going to study is silk industry. India is well known for silk industries. Okay. India is the second largest producer of raw silk next to China. From where will they get that raw material? That is by rearing silk worm. What is it known as? Rearing of silk worm is known as sericulture. In order to carry out this sericulture, they are in need of a large number of labor. So it is called as labor intensive industry. And it provides employment to 7.56 million people, make to weaker and marginalized sections of society. Karnataka is the largest producer of silk. Every year, 8,200 metric tons of silk is produced in Karnataka. It is one third of the total, we can say. Bihar, Jharkhand, one third of India's total production. Other producers are West Bengal, Jammu and Kashmir, Bihar, Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, Uttar Pradesh, Punjab, Assam and Tamil Nadu. India exports silk to other countries like Europe, USA, UK, Russia, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait and Singapore. Here you can see some details that is about silk industries. Central Silk Research Institute, okay, that is CSTRI, is the only research institute in the country dedicated to the research and development activities related to silk technology. This CSTRI was established in the year 1983 by the Central Silk Board, that is under Ministry of Textiles. Government of India having headquarter at Bangalore, we can say. Okay, Ministry of Textiles, Government of India, that is with headquarters at Bangalore, we can say. Next one, development, do you know? Development Commissioner for Handlooms, this is general detail. Development Commissioner for Handlooms was set up as an attached non-participating office on 20th November 1975. Under the Ministry of Commerce. At present, it is functioning under the Ministry of Textiles. Its headquarters is located at Udyog Bhavan, New Delhi. Next, you are going to study about sugar industry. Sugar industry is considered as the raw material oriented industry. It can be produced from sugar cane. Sugar cane must be crushed within 24 hours of its harvest. Or else what will happen? The sucrose content will get reduced. At present, sugar industry is the largest industry next to cotton textile industry in India. India stands in the second place next to Brazil. It also provides employment to 2.86 lakh people. In India, Uttar Pradesh is the largest producer of sugar, producing about 50% of the country's total. Other producers of sugar may be Maharashtra, கர்நாடகா, ஆந்திரப்பிரதேஷ், தமிழ்நாடு, பீகார், பஞ்சாப், குஜராத், ஹரியானா அண்ட் மத்திய பிரதேஷ். நெக்ஸ்ட் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு ஸ்டடி அபவுட் ஃபாரஸ்ட் பேஸ்ட் இண்டஸ்ட்ரீஸ். த இண்டஸ்ட்ரீஸ் விச் ட்ரா தே ரா மெட்டீரியல்ஸ் ஃப்ரம் ஃபாரஸ்ட் ஆர் கால்ட் அஸ் ஃபாரஸ்ட் பேஸ்ட் இண்டஸ்ட்ரீஸ். ஓகே, ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு ஸ்டடி அபவுட் தட் பேப்பர் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி. ஓகே, த பேப்பர் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பேப்பர் மில் ஆஃப் இந்தியா வாஸ் ஸ்டார்டட் இன் த இயர் 1812 அட் சராம்பூர் இன் வெஸ்ட் பெங்கால். பேப்பர், வென் வி சே தெர் ஆர் வேரியஸ் டைப்ஸ் ஆஃப் பேப்பர்ஸ் அவைலபிள், தே ஆர் ப்ரொடியூஸ்ட் ஃபார் வேரியஸ் யூஸ் சச் அஸ் ஷீட் பேப்பர், பேப்பர் பாக்ஸஸ், டிஷ்யூஸ், பேப்பர் பேக்ஸ், ஸ்டேஷ்னரி, என்வலப்ஸ் அண்ட் பிரிண்டட் பேப்பர் ப்ராடக்ட்ஸ் சச் அஸ் புக்ஸ், பீரியாடிக்கல்ஸ் அண்ட் நியூஸ் பேப்பர்ஸ். த சாஃப்ட்வுட் இஸ் த மேஜர் ரா மெட்டீரியல் ஆர் பிரின்சிபல் ரா மெட்டீரியல் ஃபார் மேக்கிங் நியூஸ் பிரிண்ட் அண்ட் ஹை கிளாஸ் பிரிண்டிங் பேப்பர்ஸ். வாட் இஸ் நியூஸ் பிரிண்ட்? நியூஸ் பிரிண்ட் இஸ் நத்திங் பட் த பேப்பர் விச் இஸ் யூஸ்ட் ஃபார் பிரிண்டிங் நியூஸ் பேப்பர், மேகசின்ஸ் எக்ஸெட்ரா. ஓகே, ஸோ பேப்பர் இஸ் வெரி வெரி இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ஃபார் அவர் எஜுகேஷனல் சிஸ்டம் ஆல்சோ. டு யூ அக்ரி? Yes, it is very very important for our education. We are using the paper to write. We have the books with paper. So, it is very very useful for education. The first successful effort was made only in the year 1867 with the setting up of the Royal Bengal Paper Mills at Baliganj near Kolkata. The raw materials for paper industry may be wood pulp, bamboo, சாலை அண்ட் சபை கிராஸ், வேஸ்ட் பேப்பர் அண்ட் பகாசி. வாட் இஸ் பகாசி? பகாசி இஸ் எ பிளாக் சிரப் விச் இஸ் எ பை ப்ராடக்ட் ஆஃப் சுகர் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி. ஓகே, விச் இஸ் எ பை ப்ராடக்ட் ஆஃப் சுகர் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி. வெஸ்ட் பெங்கால் இஸ் த லார்ஜஸ்ட் ப்ரொடியூசர் ஃபாலோட் பை மத்திய பிரதேஷ், ஒடிசா அண்ட் தமிழ்நாடு. த நெக்ஸ்ட் இண்டஸ்ட்ரி மே பி மினரல் பேஸ்ட் இண்டஸ்ட்ரீஸ். What is mineral based industry? The industries which depend on minerals. Okay, it may be metallic mineral or non-metallic mineral. First we may see about the iron and steel industries. This iron and steel industry is known as the basic or key industry. Why it is known so? Because all the industries, whether it is a small scale or medium or large or cottage, whatever may be, they use some machineries to produce their products. Those machineries are obtained only from iron and steel industries. Because of that, it is called as a key industry or basic industry. Several industries like engineering, heavy machines and machine tools, automobile, locomotives and railway equipment industries use iron and steel as their primary raw material. The modernization of this iron and steel industry was started only in the year 1907. The first iron and steel industry was started by Jamshedji Tata. Okay, it was known as, or it is known as, Tata Iron and Steel Company. It was started in Jamshedpur. This is the private sector unit. Even now, it is the one and only private sector iron and steel industry. You can see that table here. There are so many industries. Tata Iron and Steel Company, which is located at Jamshedpur, started in the year 1911. Its proper production was started only in the year 1911. What is the product produced by them? Pig iron. The second one may be Indian Iron and Steel Company. It was in three different places, that is Burnpur, Hirpur and Kulti. It was started in 1972 and products produced by them may be pig iron, crude steel. Third one may be Visveshwaraya Iron and Steel Company. It is located at Bhadravati in Karnataka. Started in the year 1923, producing the products alloy and sponge steel. And then we have Hindustan Steel Limited in that is different places. One is in Bhilai, Rourkela, Durgapur and Bokaro. The industry in Bhilai is collaborated with Russia. It was started in the year 1957 and producing products like railway equipments and shipbuilding. An industry in Rourkela is collaborated with Germany, started in the year 1965 and producing hot and cold rolled sheets. And the next one, Hindustan Steel Limited, that is in Durgapur, which is collaborated with UK, United Kingdom, started in the year 1959, producing alloy steel and railway equipment. And the last or fourth Hindustan Steel Limited is Bokaro. In Bokaro, it is collaborated with Russia, started in the year 1972, producing the products sludge and slag. Next one, Salem Steel Limited, that is in Tamil Nadu, started in the year 1982, producing stainless steel products. The next one, Vijayanagar Steel Plant, again it is in Karnataka, started in the year 1994, producing flat steel and long steel. And the one of the shore-based steel plant is Visakhapatnam Steel Plant, located in Andhra Pradesh, started in the year 1981, producing hot metal. Okay, so these are all about the various iron and steel industries. Okay, as it is shown in the table, we have many other industries under public or government undertaking collaborated with some countries. As I said, that it may be collaborated with Russia or UK or Germany. For what purpose they are collaborated? It may be for technical assistance or financial assistance, or sometimes labor may be obtained from them. The next industry is automobile industry. The first automobile industry of India was started in 1947. Only after independence, this industry has been developed a lot. The first industry is the Premier Automobiles Limited, that was started at Kurla in Mumbai. It was followed by the Hindustan Motors Limited at Uttarpara, Kolkata. Now, we stand as the seventh largest producer of automobile manufacturers. What are the various centers where we have these automobiles? At Mumbai, Chennai, Jamshedpur, Jabalpur, Kolkata, Pune, New Delhi, Kanpur, Bengaluru, Sadara, Lucknow, Mysore. They are manufacturing various types of vehicles. It may be four-wheeler or two-wheeler or anything. The passenger car manufacturers are Tata Motors, Maruti Suzuki, Mahindra and Mahindra, and Hindustan Motors. Presence of foreign car companies may be like Mercedes-Benz, Fiat, General Motors, Toyota, BMW, Audi, Volkswagen, and Volvo. The automobile industries are found in four clusters. They are Delhi, Gurgaon, and Manesar in North India, Pune, Nasik, Kalol, and Aurangabad in West India, Chennai, Bengaluru, and Hosur in South India, and Jamshedpur and Kolkata in East India. Okay, in four clusters they are divided. The next industry may be electrical and electronic industries. Heavy electrical industries manufacture equipment used for power generation, transmission, and utilization. Turbines of steam and hydropower plants, boilers for thermal plants, generators, transformers, switch gears, or the various chief products which are produced under the electrical and electronic industries. Which is the most important electronic industry in India? That is Bharat Heavy Electricals Limited. Bengaluru is considered as the electronic capital of India. The major producer of electronic goods centers are Hyderabad, Delhi, Mumbai, Chennai, Kolkata, Kanpur, Pune, Lucknow, Jaipur, and Coimbatore. The last industry what we are going to study is software industry. India is home to some of the finest software companies of the world. This industry began in 1970 with the entry of TCS, that is Tata Consultancy Service. Along with this, L&T, Infotech are the major industries. At present, 500 software companies are there, exporting nearly to 95 countries in the world. Last one, we can see the major challenges faced by the Indian industries. What are the major challenges? The first one may be shortage and fluctuation in power supply. Okay, we have that power supply fluctuation often. That is one of the major problem. Then we are not able to get proper land for starting an industry. The third one may be they are not able to get proper credit facilities to start the industry. Fourth one, high rate of interest for borrowed loan. Fifth one, they are not able to get cheap laborers. Sixth one, lack of technical and vocational training for employees. The employees are not trained. And last one, inappropriate living conditions nearby industrial, that is the place where they live. It is not an appropriate place. Okay, inappropriate living conditions nearby industrial estate. That is the final drawback. Thank you, students.